First, I'd like to start by telling a little bit about myself. I was born in Roanoke, Virginia in 1969. Around the same time, media in Roanoke were conducting interviews downtown about gun control while demonstrators were marching to protest the exclusion of two African-American women from the then-named National Business College. I was a baby then, of course, but I suspect between the goo-goos and gaga's of my parents, their baby talk consisted of a good amount of subconscious community-involved chatter. Their activism certainly rubbed off on me. My mother was, at that time, the president of the NAACP in Virginia, and my father, with his bell-bottom pants, was a rather outspoken minister on civil rights and diversity issues. You think we had it tough now? What my parents were doing back in the 60s and early 70s made our lives more livable and was very different compared to Facebook petitioning today. I grew up in Roanoke, went to William Fleming High School, then on to Hampton University. Following that, I continued executive management training at the Robert C. Maynard Institute for Journalism Education, Kellogg School of Business, at Northwestern University. I'm also a proud member, as you can see here, of Omega Psi Phi Fraternity, a member of the National Association of Black Journalists. My career in journalism began in 1991 at Seattle Times, as one of the first two Times Fellows given a crash course experience in real world of media operations. I soon discovered how she said that a lot of activity concerning communities of color never made it into the mainstream media. I launched Colors Northwest magazine in Seattle, Washington. 5 years after its launch in 2001, Colors Northwest grew to a readership of more than 62,000 readers a month. We won over 70 journalism awards and was Magazine of the Year in 2006 in the Seattle region. Great inspired stories, but we didn't shy away from controversial subject matter. But we were proud of the controversial stories. We featured the impact of communities of color, like the backlash against Muslims and Arabs in 9/11, the plight of victims of Hurricane Katrina, and the tensions between ethnic groups and many other issues. But I will believe this is vital in accomplishing a unifying and not divisive result. Always we sought to bring common humanity of people we featured in our stories. We respected the differing perspectives in making complex stories accessible to all. We showed the human faces behind the controversies and the political posturing. We showed why stories of national and international significance impact all of us in local communities. And you know what we often found? That polarizing stories often turned out not actually polarizing, but instead opportunities for understanding and bringing folks with differences together. So jumping forward to 2015, my mother is getting on in years. She lives in Roanoke. So I decided to return home to Roanoke from Seattle. Roanoke's changed a lot since I grew up, but there's a lot more changing that is still needed. I'm not going to quote the stats, but we know national trends of Roanoke is no different. Racially divided housing location is still predominant. Poverty is still primarily impacting communities of color. Communities of color have the lowest education levels and institutionalized racism continues. But thankfully, more is coming to light. A message of inclusion and mutual respect is needed in Roanoke. So in 2015, in July, we launched the first edition of Colors Virginia Magazine. Again, we didn't shy away from the difficult issues. In the first three issues, we featured stories from the Confederate flag, Native Americans, and same-sex marriage. The response has been tremendous and wholly affirming. There's nothing like this in Southwest Virginia. Print publications are tough. Advertising is what makes the wheels go round. In just 3 months, we've been joined by all the supporters and influential advertisers who quickly grasp the value and need for the regional publication targeting communities of color. ColorsVA magazine is primarily a lifestyle magazine with fresh, in-depth content for and about local communities of color, including our Taste Buds column on ethnic restaurants. But there's much more to do. How to more directly address economic disparities attached to communities of color? We believe part of the answer lies with employer, potential employee. Ethnic communities express difficulty in locating employers. open to, and even desiring a workforce that better reflects the diversity of the region. At the same time, employers express frustration not able to find quality candidates of color. Before 2006 rolls around, we'll be launching ColorsVAcareers.com, an online regional-based job database for communities of color, specifically just designed to bring quality professionals and managerial candidates of color together with companies who want them. Many companies want to select their top candidates from a candidate pool that actually reflects the diversity of the marketplace. We'll be enabling this to happen. The focus will be exclusively in Southwest Virginia, with Roanoke being the largest population in the region. So, what does success look like for Colors Virginia Magazine and ColorsVirginiaCareers.com? Well, call me an idealist, but I'm aiming for a Colors Virginia Magazine to bring about a region where all folks from all communities live alongside each other with mutual respect, to bring forth love for one another as individuals of equal value and worth, celebrating our similarities, understanding our differences. I envision ColorsVAcareers.com bring about an employee mix that actually reflects the diversity of this region. I envision the salary levels of communities of color being equal to the salary levels of the general population. Will we succeed? Well, who knows? But mediocrity is a never-ending rising tide, and we must fight it. It is time for communities of color in Roanoke and throughout Southwest Virginia to have a voice, to be heard, to be fully embraced, honored, welcomed, and included in the larger universal voice of humanity. Thank you.